Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In the last video, we have reached this stage. And if you did not watch the first video, you will find the link in the description. The process of separating lead from gold and silver is a mining operation that requires specialized equipment and techniques, and should not be carried out randomly or without proper knowledge. We will first start by making a cement crucible in this form. In fact, there are several methods that I have mastered well. Among these methods are: litharge is the basic flux component and the source of lead to do the collecting. The mixture of ore and litharge is placed in an assy crucible. The crucible is heated in the assy furnace, which reduces the litharge to lead and liquefies the charge. The process and its product is called fusion. The fusion is poured into a cast iron mold, where it forms a lead button. The lead button is placed in a cupola cylindrical block usually made of bone ash, with a shallow cup on top, and the cupola is heated in an oxidizing atmosphere with the draft open or the door cocked. Today we will use the lead fumigation method. How do we evaporate lead found in a sample? But when fumigation is an artistic method, fire, air, and an elaborate cement crucible. To know the whole method, follow the video until the end so you don't miss any details of the process. Please like and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to get new video updates. If you are dealing with small quantities of these metals, you can consider various methods of separation based on the physical properties of each metal. However, it is strongly recommended to collaborate with professionals in the mining industry if you are planning larger scale mining operations. In general, strict regulations and safety measures must be followed in any mining operation to ensure that it is conducted safely, using safety gear such as gloves, goggles, and a respirator is mandatory. There are secrets to vaporizing lead. Watch how the process of fumigating the lead present in the sample is done to separate the gold and silver when the fumigation is done in an elaborate manner. Sometimes with fire and air, sometimes just fire, and sometimes both together. In this way, lead decreases with each fumigation. As you evaporate, turn off the fire, stop for a while, then evaporate again, and so on until the lead is almost completely reduced. If you vape, try to learn twice until you become a pro. The process requires effort, patience, time, and knowledge. This sample is small, but if it is large in kilograms, you will need to gain enough experience to work. This is how he extinguished the fire, turning on the air alone, then turning on the air and the fire, then turning on the fire alone, and so on, until you see the lead decreasing with each vaporization, and becoming like the sun. It has light, and the more it decreases, it returns like a planet to the center and becomes smaller until you are left with gold and silver. If you burn in the correct manner, you will get gold and silver. I did not use this method before, but I learned it from Cheikh Najib, the owner of a channel on YouTube in the Arabic language. And I thank him, by the way. And whoever wants his address will find it. Link in the description box. There are several ways. I will reveal it to you in upcoming videos. In lead smelting and refining operations, the precious metal values are primary precious metals from the lead ore. The lead is melted in large cast iron kettles. Molten zinc is then poured into the liquid lead, and rabbled stirred into the lead where it combines with the precious metals. Floats up to the top and is skimmed off as a zincly dross. This is known as the Parks process. The precious metals are separated by conventional methods such as removing the zinc by distillation and the lead by cupellation or by wet acid methods, and then parted and refined as usual. A reverse Parks process can be undertaken. Using lead as a collector, add crushed ore or ground black sands to molten lead, rabble them in, Skim off the gang mostly sand quartz, add molten zinc, and collect the values. This is called a lead scarification. In a fire assay, lead is used to collect the precious metal values in an ore. In order to determine the value of the ore expressed in ounces per ton, a weighed sample of the ore in question is crushed and roasted to a dull heat to expel the sulfides. The ore is mixed with a flux containing litharg. Litharg is the basic flux component and the source of lead to do the collecting. The mixture of ore and litharg is placed in an assay crucible. The crucible is heated in the assay furnace, which reduces the litharg to lead and liquefies the charge. The process and its product is called fusion. The fusion is poured into a cast iron mold, where it forms a lead button. The lead button is placed in a cupola cylindrical block, usually made of bone ash, with a shallow cup on top, and the cupola is heated in an oxidizing atmosphere with the draft open or the door cocked. In the SE furnace, the lead and the oxidizable metals are reduced to oxides lead to litharge, copper to copper oxide, and so on, and these oxides are absorbed by the cupola, leaving behind a precious metal bead that is weighed and parted chemically to determine the precious metal values. Often, in quartz of pure silver are added to the crucible fusion to ensure a good parting in an assay for gold and silver. Enough pure silver is added to lower the in quartz, which you buy, come with an assayed weight, which is deducted from your results based on the assay of the in quartz and the total weight used. Now we will return to our topic today, which is vaporization. Sometimes by fire, sometimes by air, and sometimes by fire and air together. Please like and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to get new video updates. In the end, we had an alloy that looked like this, with the middle filled with gold, silver, and some impurities. But what is noticeable here is that the lead has actually evaporated completely or almost all of it. Here we will move to the next stage, which is a chemical stage. For this reason, wait for us in the next video.